Now, China's President Xi Jinping has said that Hong Kong protests are illegal and insisted that law and order must be maintained. He made those comments at the end of a press conference in Beijing on Wednesday with President Obama, who said that America had played no role in the protests. His comments may signal the end of China's tolerance for the protests, which have paralyzed parts of Hong Kong for nearly 2 months now. Well, someone who has been covering the pro-democracy protests, every detail of them, in fact, since they began, is journalist Tom Grundy, and I'm pleased to say that he joins me now from Hong Kong. Tom, good to see you. You know, you are the man that everybody, when I was in Hong Kong, was saying, what's Tom Grundy saying? What's he saying on Twitter? What are the pictures that he's got up? I mean, you really were, and still are, at the very heart of this protest movement in terms of reporting it. What is your assessment of the situation at the moment?
Well, rumours are rife about a possible police clear-out in the coming days. There's conflicting reports about when, but there are these court orders, high court injunctions that allow bailiffs to clear certain areas. And I was in Mong Kok last night, where there's been some unrest before. Some protesters there told me that they may resist. They may occupy new areas even. Politics are a little more radical there than at the main protest camp in Admiralty. Their protesters, mostly students, are more dug in. There's over 2,000 tents, artworks, a study centre, and many there say that they won't resist police action. Meanwhile, student leader Joshua Wong has actually said that he's ready to be arrested, and the original convener of the movement, Benny Tai, said that he will hand himself in for arrest.
I mean, we've heard these kind of lines before, haven't we, of information from the protest leaders and also getting a sense that perhaps things are moving and then they don't. We could almost be having this conversation 4 weeks ago when I was there. I'm just keen to find out from you if you think that there is an end game or this is actually going to signify a really interesting point in the protest in the coming days.
Well, from what officials and local media have been saying, it does seem that police may move in using minimal force. They came under criticism for using tear gas early on in the protest. So it's perhaps likely that batons and pepper spray will be used if there is any kind of resistance. But Chief Secretary Carrie Lam said that there is now no more room for dialogue, and she's called the student side insincere. So I don't see at the moment any room for more talks. So as we go into the 47th day, it seems that this is the end game now, the last few days of this pro-democracy movement.
Tom, we're going to have to leave it there, but we're grateful for your time. And just to say, we have been showing our viewers some of the images that you've captured over the last few weeks or so. But thank you very much. Tom Grundy there.